Hey guys, welcome back. What if you can measure the health of your solar panel array while your system is running without invasive probing or risk of electric shock? Well, now you can with PVBuddy. Today we are reviewing and testing an irradiance sensor that can assess the health of a single solar panel or a string of solar panels connected in series. We will first see how the app is used and then we'll jump into the testing. If you often make seasonal angle of incline adjustments to your panel to optimize output, you might find this useful. This video is sponsored in that PVSure, makers of PVBuddy, gave me this sensor for free in order to make this video. I do not get any commission from purchases made on the PVBuddy website, but I may in the future if and when it becomes available on Amazon. If you are new to solar and have not seen my video, Testing Solar Panels for Beginners, please check it out as this video builds upon that. So what are the differences between using an irradiance sensor versus a standard MPPT solar tester? Let's find out. All right, let's see what we got in the box. PVBuddy quick start guide. Simple enough. Couple of cables. We got a USB A to C adapter cable, and we got a USB A to C adapter. And of course, the PVBuddy irradiance sensor. In order to use the irradiance sensor, you will need three things: the sensor, any DC clamp meter, and the PVBuddy mobile app. The PVBuddy app is available in the Google Play Store and currently supports Android devices only. The sensor requires power from a USB power source, such as your phone or portable USB power bank / charger. Using a separate USB power bank allows you to perform testing from a distance, away from the hot sun. The app can communicate with the sensor in two ways. Direct Wi-Fi. The app connects directly to the sensor via point-to-point Wi-Fi connection. This mode is useful when a Wi-Fi router is not available. For example, if your solar array is remotely located, or you want to quickly test some used panels you are thinking of purchasing, home Wi-Fi router. Both the app and sensor communicate via your Wi-Fi router. Use this method when you need to perform testing often and for faster testing once set up. There are a couple more benefits using this method, but we will cover those later. There are three check modes available when testing panels. String Watt. This is useful when you want to compare a single string of solar panels against your charge controller, for example. This mode does not require the use of a clamp meter. String Amp. Use this mode when checking more than one series string of panels connected in parallel. This mode requires a clamp meter. Module Amp. Use this mode when checking a single panel, clamp meter required. This will be our first test. Okay, we're going to do our single panel test. This is a 100 watt Renogy solar panel. It's brand new. When you're testing single panels, you want to take the ends of the cords and just short them together. Only do this with one panel. So we'll go into our app. We'll select our Renogy 100 watt profile. Our quantity is set to 1. And our total string wattage is 100 watts. Go to begin check, and you want to make sure the test mode is under module amp. There's several different modes. There's string watts for testing strings using watts, and testing strings using amps. But we're going to test a module, a single module, using amps. So we're getting an irradiance value of 970, which is pretty close to 1000. 1000 is the test value they used in the standard test conditions when manufacturing solar panels. It's not required to be 1000, but anything over 1000 is good. It's good sunlight. So what we're going to do, the app, based on the irradiance, it's expecting to see a clamp meter reading of 5.06 amps. So if we get anywhere close to that using our clamp meter, that means the panel is okay. So I got my clamp meter switched to DC amps, and it's zeroed out the meter. Just put the clamp meter on your wire. Okay, so our clamp meter is showing about 5.3 amps. So we'll take this up to 5.3. Our expected value is 5.05. So it looks like this panel is going to pass. I'll click check. And it's good, just 3% off. Yeah, so this panel is good. Okay, now we're going to use the same 100 watt panel, but we're going to shade it. So I shaded
just half of one column. That should be enough to reduce the amps quite significantly.
Okay, so our Irradiance is over 1,000, so that's really good. We'll move our slider up to 3.7, that's our clamp meter reading. And our expected value is now 5.23, so it's went up based on our Irradiance. So this will definitely be a fail. I'm guessing 50% or more. Nope, 29%.
That was close.
So by shading one column, you can see that we lost 29% of the panel's output.
Let's review. When testing single panels, short the module connectors and read the amp value with the clamp meter. Wait for a steady clamp meter reading and Irradiance value before checking. This test uses the ISC value from the solar panel specs.
Okay, now I have a string of panels. We have two 100 watt solar panels connected to this test solar system. And we're going to measure a string of panels.
Okay, so we got these two panels. They're brand new. They're 100 watts each. So we have a total of 200 watts going into our test solar system.
We can see that we're getting 175 watts. So when you test a single string connected to a single MPPT tracker, you want to use the watts mode. We first want to select the correct profile. So we're going to do our energy, 100 watt, and we have two in a string. That gives us a total of 200 watts. And we'll just update the text here. This text shows on the test screen. So we've got 100 watt, quantity 2, 200 watts. Should be good to go here. Okay, so we need to switch this to string watt. We can see that the expected wattage based on our Irradiance value is 170 watts. Our Irradiance value is 980, say. And our expected wattage is 171. So you can use this wattage value to compare against your equipment, as long as it's one series string per MPPT. When you test multiple strings, you need to use a clamp meter. We'll get to that later. 175 watts on our charge controller. And when you do this test, you want to make sure your battery is at a low state of charge, so your charge controller is pulling as much power as possible from the solar panels. Yeah, so our battery state of charge is actually 27%. All right, so we're going to take this value, 176 watts, from our charge controller, and we're going to put that in our slider value here. And our expected value is 170 at this point. Click check. And we're just 4% off, so still within good range. So that's how it is. That's how easy it is to check a single string series of panels. You don't have to use a clamp meter. You can use watts, so that's kind of cool. And when you're testing a series string, it uses the Pmax value on the back of your panel. Okay, now we're going to shave one of the panels and create a huge wattage drop and see if we can detect that as well. Oh, look at that. Our power dropped down to 99 watts, so this should be a good test. I think it just went to bypass.
These panels have bypass diodes, and they're really actually quite good panels for being $100 panels. We have to shade more than one column here.
We just need this to stabilize here. Okay, so we're going to go with 50 watts as our input value. We can see that our expected wattage should be 164 based on our Irradiance of 938. So we'll put in 50. Click check.
Yep, so we have a degradation of 69%.
What you would need as a good input value to get the expected value, so 164, right? If we moved it to 164, 165, it would be considered okay, right? But that's not our input value. Our input value is actually, you know, 65, so you're just kind of matching the expected value based on the Irradiance sensor and the input value, whether it's amps or watts.
Let's review. String watt mode is useful for checking if your equipment is functioning optimally. This test uses the Pmax value on the solar panel specs and does not require a clamp meter.
Nine panel array. It's a 3S 3P configuration, so we have three strings of three and then they're connected in parallel. So all these nine panels, three strings going into a single MPPT but combined before the inverter. Okay, so when we did the string testing on the test solar system, we used wattage, and you can only use that on a single MPPT string. But what happens when you have all three strings, more than one string connected together in a series parallel configuration before the MPPT controller? Your controller is going to give you a total wattage of all nine panels. So how do you figure out if you want to know if one string is performing better than the others? Because I have two strings facing south and one string is facing west, and the two strings, they're all at different angles. So instead of using watts at that point, you're going to have to use amps using the clamp meter. Okay, so all nine panels come into this inverter charger, and it's only got one MPPT on this charger, and you can see we're getting 1.26 kilowatts for all nine panels. Okay, so a couple things about this string. This string is made up of uneven panels, so the larger panels are 335 watt panels and the smaller panels are 250 watt panels. So when you test a string with uneven panels, you want to use the lowest value panel when you're setting up your test profile. We're basing it on the smaller Trina panels, 250 watts, and we got quantity 3. So each string can produce a theoretical max of 750 watts. And we have three strings. So if 750 times 3, that'd be 2,250 watts total. So when we were testing the other string, we were in string watt mode. And you can see the expected value is 511 watts. Well, we're getting 1.29 kilowatts on our inverter. So you can see that this is way off. So you have to switch it to string amp. So just like testing a single string, you want to make sure your charge controller is in bulk mode so that we're pulling all the power, as much power as possible from the solar panels. So our battery state of charge is at 51%, so we're in bulk mode. So our expected meter reading for this string is 6.50 amps. And this value is based off of the IMP, or amps at max power, not the short circuit power like the single panel, but we're going, since it's when you're connected to the charge controller, it's going to be your current at max power, Pmax. So our reading should be 6.57, and we're getting 6.6. So let's put in 6.6. Our radiance is stable, 6.5. Check. And it's perfect. We're within range.
Let's review. String amp mode is useful for testing solar panel arrays, especially if you have multiple parallel strings combined on a single MPPT tracker. This test uses the current at Pmax or IMP value on the solar panel specs.
So another thing that's pretty cool about this Irradiance sensor is if you make seasonal adjustments to your panels, like it's October now, so you want to have the panels steeper, more at a steeper angle towards the sun, you can use this as a protractor or incline finder just by looking at the Irradiance value. So you can see these panels are at different angles. This is about 60 degrees and these are about, I don't know, 34 degrees. But if I put the sensor at the same plane and the same angle, parallel with this panel here, as this panel, we can see our Irradiance value is 765. If I go to this panel over here, it's 770. But if I go to this panel over here, we can see it's at 800, 816, 820.
So all you would have to do to find the best alignment for your season
is to just move your sensor and look at the number until you achieve the highest number. You want to do it at midday. So right about this angle, 830, 840, 850. So my panels are not optimized. I could definitely optimize this. Looks like about that angle right there. I think that's about 70 degrees. Yeah, about right here, 850 is the max that I can get. If I go this way, it starts to go down again. So yeah, right about here. So actually that panel right there is actually where it should be at. Yep, battery's at 52. We're still putting 1,000 watts into the battery. So 6.50 amps should be our clamp reading. Let's see what we get. This panel is actually shaded. Both of these panels on this string is shaded, so it's actually not very good at all. 2 amps. So let's bring this down to 2. It's going to be pretty bad. Let's give it let's go 2.1. Let's give it the benefit of the doubt here. Okay. Click check. And that's pretty minus 67% for this string. Wow, that's horrible. So this string is pretty much optimized. This string here is, well, it's shaded for one thing, and this panel is at not an optimal angle, so minus 67% on this one. That's really bad.
Using the Irradiance sensor to align panels is quick and easy. It can even work in overcast conditions as long as you get a stable irradiance value.
So I've used these panels for quite a while, and I know the fact that they only produce about 200 watts in the best of conditions. So we're going to see if this sensor can detect a degraded panel. So right off the bat, we can tell this panel is degraded because the clamp meter reading is 5.5 and our expected reading is 6. So it's consistently lower. The clamp meter value will always be lower than the expected value if you have a degraded panel.
So let's try to go ahead and do a test. So I'll put 5.6 in here just to give it the benefit of the doubt here. And it's still off by 8%.
So it's 8% lower. The clamp meter reading was 8% lower than the expected value here. So this panel is at least 10% derated from once it was first manufactured.
So say 250 watts minus 10%.
225 is the max I can expect out of this panel. Yeah, so the difference between the Irradiance sensor and using a standard MPPT tester is that there's no VOC limit like this one has, because you're not dealing with voltage, you're dealing with amps or watts when you're using the Irradiance sensor. You also do not need to disconnect the cables from the solar panel when you want to test a single series string or multiple series strings connected in parallel. Also, you can use the sensor in less than ideal conditions. As long as you have a consistent light and a consistent clamp meter reading, your reading will be accurate. So it can be perfectly overcast or perfectly sunny outside and you'll still get an accurate reading. It's apples to apples. And the last thing I want to mention is the Irradiance sensors are typically found on high-end test equipment. So PV Sure is trying to basically fill that gap between something like this and a $4,000 solar test equipment. All right, so things I don't like about the sensor, the Wi-Fi connection is probably the biggest contention point. The app only supports Android right now and it only supports 2.4 gigahertz. So if you have a 5 gigahertz Wi-Fi router, you can't do the router setup, which I didn't do in this video because all it really does is enables you save the password and username of the router into the device and then it can reconnect automatically. That's really the only difference versus just connecting it to your phone each time. So I just did that in the video. I just connected each time. But yeah, that's it. Thanks for watching and I'll see you guys on the next one. Being okay to being over. It'll still say like okay if you're at like 0%, 1%, 2%, or 3%. What's this guy? Look at him.